Hi, boys and girls. Welcome to my home office. I'll give you a quick tour and then we'll get started with something I'd like for you to have some clarification on today. So here's my office. Pretty typical room where I work from behind my computer every day. I just want to give you a little bit more information on what we've been discussing with our learned behaviors and our inherited traits. So today I want to talk about our inherited traits. Those are things like our instincts. They're in our DNA, which is in our nucleus of every cell in our body. They're handed down from our parents to us. So all humans have some instincts that they know how to do from birth. A couple of those would be, you guys are born knowing how to breathe, right? Deep breath in, deep breath out. You do that and you don't even know you're doing it all day long. You also are born knowing how to blink your eyes. So you just naturally blink them. No one has to teach you how to blink your eyes. Those are some of your instincts. Now you also have inherited traits from your mom or dad. Hair color, eye color, your skin tone, all of those are great examples of those inherited traits from mom and dad. That's in your DNA. Now when we go on to learn behavior, those are things that you've acquired over time. Those are traits that you've acquired or developed. So some of those, like Miss Abbott, I know how to play the piano, not well, but I will say that's one of my learned behaviors or my acquired trait is that I can play the piano. Some of you gave me an example of being athletic as an inherited trait. And some of you gave me being athletic as a learned behavior last week. So I want to talk a little bit about that today. So let's say you think that your athleticism comes from your mom and dad because they're super athletic. Maybe your dad played basketball for Florida. I had to get that in there. Maybe your mom was on the basketball team in high school, and so you think that you play basketball really well because your parents played basketball really well. And that might be true. Some of you thought that being really good at basketball was a learned behavior because you've practiced every day after school. You get out there and you shoot hoops and you play on a team or you play travel ball, and you've gotten really good at playing basketball. So it might be a learned behavior. Well, there's a couple questions that we have to ask to decide if this is a learned behavior or an acquired trait, or maybe it's an inherited trait that you got from your mom or dad. We have to ask questions to decide where these traits came from. So our standard that we were looking at this week and last week has to do with these questions. So our I can statements, I'm just gonna say them to you now, just like we were in the classroom. Our I can statements are, I can ask questions to compare and contrast instincts and learned behaviors. And then I can ask questions to compare and contrast inherited and acquired physical traits. So if we wanna know where your ability in basketball came from, we might need to ask you, hey, was your mom or dad really good at basketball? Were you really good at basketball from the time you were born, from when you were really little? Maybe we need to ask you, do you practice every day? Have you honed in on that characteristic and really developed that talent year after year? So maybe it is that you're really good at it because it's inherited and your mom and dad could shoot hoops and always make the basket. Or maybe it's because you've practiced relentlessly. We'd have to ask questions to know where those traits came from, whether they were passed down to you in your DNA, or whether they were acquired traits, learned behaviors, because you've practiced. Okay, I want you to make sure you're asking yourselves these questions when you talk about whether a trait you have is from birth, from genetics, from your mom and dad, it's in your DNA, or whether it's something you've picked up over time. Thanks, guys. Bye.